still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh, easier said than done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of.
Hey, what's up, all my beautiful people? It's your boy Chris B, and we back for another cologne review today. And the fragrance that we're going to talk about today comes from the house of Lacoste, and that will be Lacoste Blanc. Lacoste Blanc. It was introduced to the market in 2011. The main accords of this fragrance is woody, citrus, aromatic, yellow floral, and tuberose. The base notes is grapefruit, cardamom, rosemary, cedar leaf, tuberose, yang yang, olibanum, atlas, cedar vetiver, leather, suede, and Georgie wood. So, I've already popped the top on this. I'm going to go ahead and give it a couple of sprays. Spray my forearm and see how it distributes, see how the itemizer work, and most importantly, see how it smells. As y'all can see, the itemizer works good. It distributes very good. So I'm going to go ahead and give it a sniff. Give it a little smell. It's very sweet. It's soft. It almost reminds me of Acqua di Gio Absolu. It has that same kind of flavor to it. Very soft, very mild. I think it smells good. I like the way that it smells. My personal experience with this bottle of cologne, back in 2014, I used to have the red version of it, and oh my God, the red version smells so good. The red one, super, super dynamite. I can't wait to buy that one again. I'm actually going to buy the red one next time instead. But this right here, I had went to Los Angeles, California back in March. And I went to a fragrance store down there. It's right there at the Fashion and Art District. I walked into one of the cologne stores, and they had a whole archive, a whole collection of cologne. I was blown away. I've never seen a cologne store this big before. So I start sniffing around, start spraying different colognes, start playing with them. And, you know, the guy that was selling the fragrances, he was educating me, and he was very knowledgeable. So I sniffed this one, and at the time I felt in love with it. I was like, damn, this smells amazing. I have to have it. So I went ahead and bought it. This is the 3.4 ounce. So with that being said, I've been wearing it for several months now. I don't think I've gotten any compliments off of this, but also I don't wear it all the time either. When I first bought it, I was excited to have it. So, you know, I used to spray this on every time I have an off day, or every time I was going out or going on a date or something. This would be my go-to fragrance. But however, I've never gotten any compliments on it, not even one. And it's not because it stinks or anything. It's probably just too soft for people to even acknowledge it or recognize it. You probably have to be close up on someone for them to actually smell you. My recommended use and recommended wears for this, I say that this is a universal fragrance. I feel that you can wear this to any event or any occasion. You can use this as a staple fragrance. I think this would be a great staple fragrance. I think you can wear this to work. You can wear this to any occasion. You'll be fine no matter what it is, whether you're going to work, school, running some errands, or going out on a date. This is a fragrance that you can just have a dumb grab on. You just grab it and spray it, and you'll be prepared for anything. It's very soft, very mild, so you won't offend anybody with this. Recommended sprays. You can definitely get away with spraying 8 sprays of this. You know, of course, hit both sides of your neck, hit behind both your ears, hit both your wrists, and hit your chest. And, you know, spray some on the back of your neck, too. And you'll be fine. Like I said, it's very soft, so it's hard to offend anybody with this. Like, you can spray the whole damn bottle, and you probably wouldn't offend anybody. I'm not suggesting that, but I'm saying if you did, it wouldn't be a problem. But don't do it, though. Recommended age for this, I say 18 and up. If you're old enough to buy cologne and you got the money to buy, I say 18 and up for real. Like I said, it's a very generic cologne. And generic does not mean bad, but I mean, it smells just like a regular standard cologne. It's really nothing mind-blowing or spectacular about this fragrance. Yes, it smells good, but that's it. It smells good. You know, I kind of almost compare this to like the Cool Waters, the Curves, the Liz Claiborne fragrances. Like I said, it's nothing spectacular about it. So if you want to buy this bottle and you want to go the retail route, you definitely can find this at Macy's or Dillard's. It usually go for about $50. And if you want to save a little bit of money, I'm sure you probably could find this on Amazon for about $40. So yeah, get on Amazon, check it out if you don't want to spend a full, you know, $50 on it and you don't mind waiting a few days to get it in the mail. The longevity and projection. The projection of this, you're probably going to get about 1 to 2 hours of projection. Longevity, you might get anywhere between 3 to 4 hours, depending on what activities you're doing for that day. Like I said, this cologne does not perform well. It smells amazing, but it does not perform well. So if you do decide to buy this fragrance, this is one that you probably will have to reapply throughout the day. Say if you work an 8-hour shift, you know, after, you know, the 4-hour mark, you probably gonna have to go back to the, you know, your locker or your desk and spray on a couple of more squirts just to get you through the rest of the day. So with that being said, it's time for me to give my final review and my final rating on this. I'm going to go ahead and get this a 5 out of 10. Like I said, the projection and longevity just don't uphold the test. It doesn't impress me. It doesn't make me happy. Now, if they could find a way to reformulate this or maybe make a, you know, an EDP version of this, this is the EDT. If they could probably turn this into an EDP and, you know, make the longevity and projection stronger, it'll probably be a beast. But right now, this is right at average. It's very generic, very average, and I probably won't ever buy this again. And like I said, I don't even wear this fragrance anymore. I can't even tell you the last time I've worn this. I might have worn it a month ago, if that. I can't remember. I don't remember wearing this. I just don't grab it anymore. I don't wear it. You know, I might put this into my work rotation. That's probably what I will do, add it to my work rotation. But, hey, it's been my time. It's been real. As always, thank you for stopping by. Thank you for taking time out your busy day to come and see me. I love y'all. Thank y'all for the support. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. Without y'all, there would be no me. God bless. Much love. Chris B. signing out.